ओके, समाचार में विराम लेकर फिलहाल आपको सीधे लिए चलते हैं सीआईआई के वार्षिक सत्र में, जहां रेल मंत्री सुरेश प्रभु लोगों को संबोधित कर रहे हैं।
Didn't want to say, but those who were forced to say the budget was good, he said budget is good, but where is the implementation? I said I wish I could first implement and then present the budget. That would have been an ideal thing. So we actually gave a report, and therefore now we have a really a complete map of how we are going to do it. So this is something. Railway is so important, so critical. So therefore we are trying to work on it. Just to give an example, the Chinese have been investing the number that you just saw, about $142 billion. They keep investing every year, year after year. So what is the result? If you keep investing money of that magnitude to modernize, to expand network, to bring in more facilities, obviously the Chinese railway will be far superior to our railways. And therefore, if you want to go there, and we would definitely like to be better over a period of time, then you must do the same thing that they did, what the Japanese did, what the Europeans did. You must invest into the railways. If you don't invest and you expect the outcomes, I think that's something which I don't know how we can get it. Of course, some experts can also give a solution to that. And therefore, we really need to find out how can we make that happen, and that too in a shortest possible time. And therefore, this plan, we are now in the process of preparing even a long-term corporate plan, and that will be ready soon. So one, this budget, it is because you are from industry, this could be a music to ears. Every budget, all the our customers, we never used to call them customers also, because we said they are what the choice, they have to come to us anyway. We changed the paradigm. We said we'll appoint a customer service manager. We'll make sure that we'll actually do it, and in fact this process already started. On 25th of February, I presented a budget within 3 days. We had a first round with all our major customers, reduce the freight and also rationalize it in a significant way. So this is the first budget where the freight has not increased. So otherwise, there was no need to redo the railway budget. Only said, how much was it, 5% or 10%? That was the only thing we had to know. And that was the increase that used to happen. So we have actually not done that. And we are hoping that industry will also respond, bring more of the cargo to the railways. So the drop in freight rates will increase in the volume, eventually will lead to better revenues for the railways, because that's the 2/3 of revenue anyway coming from it. But as it was mentioned, we have a very well thought out strategy on freight, including how we can diversify the freight portfolio, also how to get more revenues. In addition to that, we are also working on making sure that we get revenues from non-rail operations. That is very critical. For railway's long-term viability, we must make sure, like some countries get as high as 20-30% of the total revenues from non-railway operation, we hardly get anything. And therefore, that is a major strategy, how to diversify and start getting non-railway revenues into the railway. That has never been thought before. We actually started working on it. Last year was the first year, had made some progress. This year will make even bigger progress, but I think this is a 5-year plan. You cannot just bring in non-rail revenue to that level within a matter of even 5 years, but we are making an effort to do that.